Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and Apple introduced Universal Control last year at WWDC as part of the macOS Monterey and iPadOS 15 updates. Apple has added it with the latest betas of macOS 12.3 and iPadOS 15.4, so it's currently in beta but should be out to the public usually within 1 to 2 months. Now, as far as supported devices, if you're wondering what device works with this, well, if you have a Mac, MacBook, MacBook Pro 2016 and later. A MacBook Air, you'll need 2018 and later, an iMac 2017 or later, as well as a 5K Retina iMac 27-inch, late 2015 or later. It works with an iMac Pro, Mac Mini 2018 and later, as well as the latest Mac Pro 2019. As far as iPads, iPad Pro, iPad Air 3rd generation and later, iPad 6th generation and later, and iPad Mini 5th generation and later. As long as you have one of those devices or a combination of them, as you see here with the iPad Pro on the left and the 9th generation iPad on the right, and this is an M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch in the middle. So this will work on these, and we can go across all devices. Now, make sure this is enabled if you want to try it out. Usually it is by default, but if we go to System Preferences, go to Displays, then click on Advanced. Under Advanced, you'll see at the top, it says, allow your cursor and keyboard to move between any nearby Mac or iPad. It says it's in beta. And then the other option that's nice is push through the edge of the display to connect a nearby Mac or iPad. So we have that option, and then you can also have it automatically reconnect to any nearby Mac or iPad. As long as that's turned on your Mac, there's also a setting on the iPad as well. So if we go to the iPad, let's just turn this down a little bit. We'll go to Settings. Under Settings, go to General. And what you can see here is it says Cursor and Keyboard Beta. Make sure that's turned on, and then this should work. Now keep in mind, it is currently in beta, so it can be a little bit buggy and sometimes not connect instantly. Sometimes it works great, sometimes it doesn't. But you will need to have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on, be on the same iCloud account, and let's go ahead and try it out. So now we'll drag to the left here. Give it just a moment. You'll see there it goes. It pops through and it's on the left on the iPad Pro. Now again, if I go to the right, we want to do the same thing with this iPad. And there we go. It pops into the iPad. And now we're controlling the cursor across all three displays. So it works pretty seamlessly and just works as expected. However, you have a great option of using the trackpad or mouse on the other devices. So on the iPad, I've got a Logitech trackpad and keyboard. I can use this one, go all the way over to this iPad and click on things or navigate through the iPad. The same is true with the Magic Keyboard. So again, I can control it from the left, go all the way to the right, and maybe on the Mac, go to Safari, and then type Apple, and it just works. So you can use any of these, as well as third-party trackpads and mice, and the Magic Trackpad works as well. So if you have these paired, maybe you have it on a third-party display, it will work seamlessly between all these devices. Another thing you can do, though, is drag and drop files between the devices. Now, if you're dragging directly to a Mac, it's pretty simple. You just go into maybe a Files app. Within Files, you'll see I have one here. We'll go to Done, and we'll drag this over to the desktop. Drop it on the desktop, and now it's on the desktop of the Mac. The same is true when we go back to the other direction. So let's close out Files and maybe drag it into Notes. So within Notes, we've got a blank note. We'll take this image here, drag it over to Notes, and now it's in Notes. So you'll see that works pretty seamlessly. Although when you're dragging something onto an iPad, you need to have an app that's going to receive that file. But again, it works the other way as well. We can drag it all the way across to this device. So if we go on this iPad here, maybe we'll go to on my iPad, then on the iPad on the left, maybe we'll grab this file here. So again, we'll grab this, drag it across multiple devices here, and drag it over to the 9th generation iPad. Now, sometimes it's not going to work 100% as it seems to have some issues from time to time. As you can see, I'm having some issues with this. There we go. We'll just split it, get rid of that, and let's maybe try the same thing one more time. So we'll grab this. We'll grab this one. Again, drag it across over to this iPad. And it's not working as intended across the iPads, but you should be able to do it in the future. And it does seem to work pretty well. Now, again, keep in mind this is in beta. Now, I did have someone ask me, will it work with Apple Pencil? And I've not found a way to do that. So you can't really use an Apple Pencil to control it across the device, at least from what I've tried. So that's how Universal Control works. It's pretty seamless and a great feature, although it is a little buggy from time to time. Sometimes it doesn't connect. I had some issues connecting to the iPad 9th generation originally, but otherwise it works great and should be available hopefully within a month or so. Although Apple will let us know when it's time for iOS 15.4 and iPadOS 15.4 and macOS 12.3. If you'd tried this out, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below how it's working for you and what device you're using it on. And of course, if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.